prosperity. It's a hope and a future. It's good to say those lines, but if you're not walking those lines, there's no need to say them. This morning, I want to let you know that there was a man in a dry brook. It was a man that did not ask for this, but committed to this. It was a man that said that I know there will be children in this lifetime will be at dry places. But I want to know to let them know there's never a drought in their life if they have me. This man is also letting it be known that even in the midst of the storms, I'm here. This morning, you got to look at your brook and you got to tell yourself there's living water there. The living water is Jesus. This morning, you got to let yourself know, too, that what do I do when my brook runs dry? I learned how to praise him in the midst of it all. You say, I know how to lift my hands and let God know that, here am I. I know how to speak against whatever the doctors have told me. But I know whatever God's will is, it will be. You got to tell yourself this morning that, devil, I don't have time to play with you. I don't care what age you are, the devil would get busy with a baby. If he can. You know how it is in church when the service going on and a song, a baby will cry out. You know how it is when your phone will go off and try to get your attention. And right now you're making sure you don't look at your phone because I'm looking at you. But you know that things happen when we're in the house of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
But I'm asking you, what are you doing to make sure that you keep the running water in your brook? Are you one of those that say Jesus and you mean Jesus? Are you one of those that said Jesus because you know that there's a catch with saying his name? This morning I asked you about the running water. How is Jesus running in your life? This morning, where are you in reference to your faith? This morning I asked you, what is the charge to keep our hand? And the God glorified.
Yeah.
Who gave his son? Well, hey. Yeah. Think about this morning with our Father.
Yes.
Jesus is calling you.
Yes, sir.
You're looking at President Trump. And what you need to be looking at is President Jesus. This morning, you're looking at what's happening on the streets. But you gotta remember the streets that are paved with gold. This morning, you're letting fear control you and not letting Jesus have his way. This morning, you're trying to make a decision about your prayer life. This morning, you're trying to find out, how do I make a change? Oh, when the river starts running dry and the brook is not giving you what you want. Can you ask yourself, God, what do I need to do to change the way of my reception?
Yes, sir.
You got to know that this morning you're being charged. You're being charged to make a difference. You're being charged to make a difference on your job. You're being charged to make a difference in your home. You're being charged to make a difference in your church. But you can't do anything unless you trust in God. I'm asking you this morning, when Elijah saw what was before him, he didn't ever say that he questioned God. It said that he moved. When God tells you to move, you better move. And when God tells you to be still and know that I am God, you better know that he is God. But this morning I'm asking you, is the fire still burning in you? If the fire is not burning in you, who put your candle out? If you haven't found the way to Jesus, I want to share it with you. I want to share when men tried to stop the brook from flowing. They nailed him to the cross.